give me a kiss to build a dream on. And my imagination will thrive upon that kiss. Oh, sweetheart, I ask no more than this. A kiss to build a dream on. Give me a kiss before you leave me. And my imagination will feed my hungry heart. Leave me one thing before we part. A kiss to build a dream on. When I'm alone with my fancies, I'll be with you, weaving romances, making believe they're true. Oh, give me your lips for just a moment, and my imagination will make that moment live. Give me what you alone can give, a kiss to build a dream on.
Survived the devastation. Some had been fortunate enough to reach safety, taking shelter in great underground vaults. When the great darkness passed, these vaults opened, and their inhabitants emerged to begin their lives again. One of the northern tribes claims they are descended from one such vault. They hold that their founder and ancestor, one known as the Vault Dweller, once saved the world from a great evil. According to their legend, this evil arose in the far south. It corrupted all it touched, twisting men inside, turning them into beasts. Only through the bravery of this Vault Dweller was the evil destroyed. But in so doing, he lost many of his friends and suffered greatly, sacrificing much of himself to save the world. When at last he returned to the home he had fought so hard to protect, he was cast out, exiled. In confronting that which they feared, he had become something else in their eyes, and no longer their champion. Forsaken by his people, he strode into the wasteland. He traveled far to the north, until he came to the Great Canyons. There he founded a small village, Arroyo, where he lived out the rest of his years. And so, for a generation since its founding, Arroyo has lived in peace, its canyons sheltering it from the outside world. It is home, your home. But the scars left by the war have not yet healed, and the Earth has not forgotten.
A little more alien looking, but still. Now, in the last game, I never really went into this because I kind of forgot, actually, amongst all the things that we did, but there are options, and I've already turned up the blood and violence to maximum. I'm not gonna increase the difficulty yet, but there is that. So it should be a little bit more bloody now, so hope everybody is well ready for this. So let's just get right on into it. Let's start a new character, and we already got similar setup, but let's start our own character. Let us be default race. You are the generic default dude. You come from a long line of generic default dudes. I'm cool with that. We will be a long-haired dude, or a bald dude, or default. Be bald. Hair? Who needs it? You're a shining beacon of no-nonsense rugged masculinity. Or maybe that's just the way the sun reflecting off your head. Either way, you're racking the chrome dome and proud of it. I think that's going to be good enough for us. Now, as we did in the last game, I'm going to be going with gifted and skilled in this one. It gives us, you gain more skill points over here per level. The trade-off is you not gain as many extra abilities, which, you know, I'm kind of fine with that. It gives us less perks. You know what? Actually, no, I'm not fine with that. Fuck that skill. I don't want that skill. And we're also going to go with energy weapons, speech, and science. I think science is a good one. This game has more science-y stuff in it than the last one. Now, we could go with more traits down here. We can go with bloody mess. We could go with bloody mess. But I don't know if I really want to. I thought about getting Jinxed just for the... I'm getting Jinxed just for the hilariousness of it. And in return, I'm going to level up my intelligence. No, not my intelligence. My luck by another. Because I think it would be a good idea. And no matter what I did at the end of Fallout 1, I'm not doing a retard character yet. I might at the end of this game show off a little bit more on that. But you know what? I don't really feel like it yet. We're gonna keep the age the same. Paticus, can we change the race? No, we can't. Something tells me that you could get mods for that, but still. So we've got our energy weapon, science, repair, or speech, or gifted. We're also jinxed. And we've already got our stats set up because we really don't need anything else. So let us, actually, I'm gonna take one out of charisma and put it into agility. I like that better. And there we go. I think we're done for now.
Come in, chosen one. There are things you must know. The village is dying. The signs are everywhere. Withering crops. Dying Brahmin.
That poor two-headed cow.
Sick children.
That just looks creepy. Uncanny valley
of... There is hope, however. A slim hope. That few know of. The old discs speak of an item called the Garden of Eden Creation Kit.
Deja vu.
It is said it can bring life to the wasteland. This will be your quest. If you prove yourself worthy. For that proof, you must first journey to the Temple of Trials. If you survive, come back to me. We will talk more. Our life is in your hands, chosen one. Prove yourself. Find the Gek. Be our salvation.
Yeah, I'm gonna be the salvation.
And they built a temple. That's actually pretty odd. You see, Clint, a fellow tribesman. Good day to you, Paticus. You may not have completed the trial of the elder, but you may not pass. I have some questions for you. Forgive me, but I have no answers. Take the trial set before you by the elder. Come on, guy. Come on. Get on. I need to go back to the village. Forgive me, Peticus, but I cannot allow you to pass. I could kick your ass and just walk out of here. Two people walking together can move the obelisk that blocks the path. Alone, you would fail. I have no intention of helping you until you pass. God damn it. It's not even going to help us. Oh, well, at least we get a spear to start out with. That's good enough for me. Even though I hate using melee weapons in this damn game. So this starting part is probably going to be one of the harder ones. As is all Fallout games. So what do we got going on here? Oh, it's an ant. I love ants. Can I hit it from here? I've actually got quite... I'm out of steel, out of range. Can I just do a... Okay, let's move one more forward. Hit it! Hit it in the head! I don't know where to hit it at. I could throw it, but someone tells me that would not work out too well. And we run away! And that's probably not for the best to actually run away. Oh, I can still attack it from back here. And we killed it. Giant ant has been slain. And the other one decides to come over here. You know what? You come to me, ant. I'm not moving towards you. Neither of us are moving. Oh, there we go. He's finally moving. I just had to skip like 2 turns to wait for him to get over here. And stab. And he's dead. This is actually a really nice spear. Thank you. Thank you, guy, for giving this to me. I greatly enjoy it. Now, you might already notice, if you did watch the original Fallout 1 Let's Play, that the graphics, not the graphics, but at least the recording is a lot smoother than it was before. And that's because, well, it's now in 720p, and that is always a good thing. So, actually, give me 1 second. So, as you might notice, that things are going to be a little bit higher resolution. Hopefully that comes out to be a bit better quality. And that should also make the audio quality a little bit better, too. Not that anyone ever complained, even when I mentioned it in the last Let's Play. But it's something that it bugs me. And hey, there's another ant. There's more stuff everywhere. There's a bunch of ants. Fuck you, ants. I don't like you. He looks unhurt, but has crippled limbs. So I'm just pretty much going against handicapped ants straight from the start. That makes me feel good about myself. Makes me feel real good about ourselves. Now, as it said in the intro, we are a member of the Arroyo tribe, who are all descendants of the original Vault Dweller, who was us in the last game. Which means we have, you know, pretty good genes, it looks like. Considering we're already level 1 and we're fighting giant ants. We are manly, minly man. Man, men, things. And these ants don't have shit on us. Well, actually this one does, because I can't hit it for shit. It's severely wounded and yet we still... There it goes. There it's dead. So what do we got going on in here? We've got a basket. A pot. Fallout, The Legend of Zelda Edition. Hey, healing butter. Mine. Oh, yeah. We also now have little depression on the floor. Can I not do anything with that? Is there anything else we got around here? What about if I were to drop it? Did not drop it properly. It's a floor depression, right? Just that. Nothing else to worry about. Okay, moving on then. What else do we got going on over here? Scorpions. Don't think I want to deal with that right now. I don't like scorpions. Scorpions are always bad news. And we're just a low level Mojave. We don't want to deal with that. There's that over there, which is lying. There's more scorpions! Fuck scorpions. I don't want to have to deal with scorpions. Scorpions suck. So what do we got going on in here? Wrong thing. It's a door! And it's locked. I already kind of